Welcome to Lesson 17 in Module 215, Advanced Behavior Management and Programming. In this very short video, we're going to kind of dig into what we mean by comprehensiveness and hopefully summarize where we've gotten to this point, as well as where we're going to go for the last few videos in this course. We talk about this concept of comprehensiveness, and what it really means is bring every tool in your toolkit to the party. Do everything that you can and stage them or combine them in the way that makes the most strategic sense for that individual. It's both a matter of our ethics as well as the most effective way to proceed. There are very few problems that will only need one intervention. That's something that the public often believes, that there's this magic pill or magic wand that solves things. In reality, things often need multiple approaches staged correctly and over a period of time. And so, summarizing much of what we covered, your job will be to combine an individuated, based on assessment approach that combines teaching, skills training, and the use of shaping programs that reinforce the progress of learning. Medical and health approaches, all the way from medication to psychotherapy to surgery and physiotherapy, many of the things we discussed at the beginning of this module. Operant approaches, which are behavioral approaches that focus on giving people rewards and consequences. Environmental setup, manipulation or management. Communication facilitation, helping people to develop ways to communicate, whether it's through skills teaching or the use of augmentative communication devices. Social asset building, giving people opportunities for meaningful relationships, including exposure to people and things like social skills. Activities in their lives that are therapeutic and meaningful and help them meet their needs. And the scheduling of those activities in a way that's suited to them as well. For example, we talked about the time of day, the frequency of things, the amount of routine, and the amount of busyness a person might experience. A set of reactive strategies that we can use, even though we're putting into place a number of proactive approaches, these are strategies that we have just in case, and we'll almost always need them. They're things that are designed to minimize any problem behavior from creating major disruption, and they should fit well with all the proactive things that we've talked about. And in the last few videos of the course, we're going to introduce three new tools to the toolkit. Talk therapy, such as counseling and psychotherapy. Systematic desensitization, which is also called exposure therapy. And classical conditioning. We're going to learn how they're used and when they're used. And that will wrap up our entire course.